Hey everyone, Claire here. Today we want to share some quick ways you can run plugins without having to leave your keyboard. Most plugins will require you to launch the plugin and interact with its UI in a modal. For some cases, it might be easier to interact with a plugin just by typing in the quick actions bar. Plugins that can be accessed in this way are using plugin parameters. Let's take a look at a few examples. Offset Resizer is a plugin that allows you to evenly add padding around any frame. Let's say you have a set of icons you want to display in your file. Instead of adding auto layout and nesting frames, we can quickly arrange them by pulling up the plugin with our quick actions bar. After pressing Command/ on Mac or Control/ on Windows, I'll type in the plugin I want to use. In this case, it's Offset Resizer. Pressing the Tab key will reveal more options where I can then type in a custom value or use the arrow keys to select the value I want. Now, my set of icons has even padding all the way around the frame. Super fast. Lucide Icons is an open source icon library that's also available as a plugin. You can quickly pull in icons through the plugin by clicking on the icon you want. You can also grab those icons using just the quick actions bar. After opening up the bar, I'll type in Lucide, then hit the Tab key. I can now browse through all the icons with the arrow keys or search for a specific icon. With over 500 icons to choose from, this is a great database to get you started on your next project. Next, we have Ghost. This plugin lets you quickly turn your high fidelity work into its loading state. Preparing loading states for your designs can be super helpful if you anticipate there to be a bit of loading time. I'll type in Ghost and then choose the color I want. After selecting gray, my screens have now been converted into placeholder loading screens. You'll notice some elements didn't all transfer over. That's because any vectors as a result of a Boolean operation or strokes aren't supported yet. This plugin is also super useful for converting high fidelity work to a lower fidelity version. Lastly, Automator lets you string together multiple Figma commands so you can further customize and speed up your workflow. For example, in the plugin UI, I've created a simple automation called Create Starter Mobile Frames. It generates specific device frames exactly where I want them. Now that it's been created, I can now type in Automator and then run my command directly from the quick actions bar. You can imagine there are infinite configurations with this plugin. There's also a playground file to explore more of Automator's capabilities. All of these plugins are using plugin parameters, which is now out of beta. This allows us to interact with the plugins without leaving our keyboards. If you're looking for more plugins with this capability, visit the link in the description. See you next time.